At the heart of Billy Thorpe's story stands mankind. This is the story of his hope and resurrection. This is the story of the 21st century man. In 1991, the big war, the Third World War, had begun. 2 billion people lost their lives in the heat of man-made suns. For the first time, humanity united in a vain effort to save planet Earth. But too late. The Earth's axis had been shifted by the atomic blasts and was moving closer toward the sun and its own destruction. Mothers, fathers, sons and daughters of the world, your time has come to leave the planet Earth forever for the kingdoms of the sun. In tunnels of light surrounded by billions of stars, a mass exodus of the surviving Earthlings traverses hyperspace in the giant crystal ships of the Sun Children. In an awe-inspiring scenario, they approach their new home, the planet Calidris, a crystal planet, the largest of seven surrounding a common sun, each having its own moon. The Earthlings are awe-stricken. Amidst blinding flashes of laser light, one by one, the ships land on their new world.
Solar
The crystal ships carrying the Earthlings have now landed. The doors of the ships open, and 1 billion sun children greet their new brothers and sisters from Earth, welcoming them to their new peaceful home. They chant, "We were watching you," telling the Earthlings how they've been observing man's inhumanity to man and of the inevitable destruction of planet Earth. Now there is new hope, new love, and new freedom to build a new world.
Thank you.
Some time has passed since the landing. The Sun Queen, daughter of the Sun King and princess of her race, chooses an Earthman for her mate. In a setting of dazzling lights and colors, she takes him to her crystal cathedral, and there, in her pleasure dome of velvet walls, upon a bed of air, she seduces him. They become lovers. As millions of people line the route in joyous celebration, the sky is lit with giant laser spotlights, paying homage to the queen of all the universe and her new crowned king from planet Earth, the 21st century man. They are the Adam and Eve of the new race. They are the future. From the union of the 21st century man and the sun goddess is born a daughter, the first child of the two races. She is the genesis of a new future. In her eyes shines the light of generations to come. The gods have brought her, blessed us with a daughter, to bring such joy to our lives. She lights the future with the sun in her eyes, glad that she's alive.
From a long dream, life is just beginning. Seems her time has arrived. She makes her entrance and immediately cries, "Good to be alive." Light is spinning, brand new sounds beginning to make their home in her mind. Tiny icy for the very first time. Good to be alive.
She's alive.
Thank you.
bribed us with their daughter to bring such joy to our lives. Light of the future with the sun in your eyes. You're alive.
Time passes, and the newborn child becomes a woman. And like her mother before her, she ascends to her destined place as queen of all the universe. As if in a dream, all the sun children gather round her, the future kings, queens, and lords of time. Stepping forth on a beam of light, she tells them of their destiny, of brave new worlds that would be formed, how planet Earth had been reborn. Rise, rise, let the light of the sun be your eyes, kings of the sun.
Stars, to the stars.